So my name's Steve Higgins, and we're going to be fishing one of the New Hampshire remote trout ponds called Black Pond. And we're right here at the beginning of what is called the Lincoln Woods Trail, which is a part of the White Mountain National Forest. And you can see over here that it's everything's maintained here by the U.S. Forest Service. So this is the Pemigewasset River. It's the East Branch. It's really, really pretty, and it's a pretty easy trail. It's pretty much flat. There's not much, as you can see, with respect to elevation, but it is about a 7-mile trip to go in and back. It's also extremely popular, and we're going to see a lot of people probably, and you can hear people in the background, because this one little area here called Franconia Falls, if I have time, I'll try to see if we can, you know, bushwhack over there a little bit and show it to you. But it's a really gorgeous set of waterfalls, smoothly carved into the granite of the rock, and it makes like these natural slides. People just love it. So this is a very, very popular trail here, and it's, you know, you'll see parents with kids and lots of stuff heading up and down this. You know, it's a nice gradual trail, especially for like a hot day today. It's like about 80 degrees, so we'll take a look. I'll show you the little bridge in a minute, and time to head out. So this is the East Branch of the Pemigewasset River, and this is the really nice little suspension bridge that they built a few years ago to allow people, so they don't have to walk across the road bridge over there. But as you can see, it's it's August. The river's not all that high, but I tell you, sometimes in the spring this place can get really, really high. And I've never really had a lot of luck fishing this river, but as you can see, because of the spring melt and stuff flowing off of the mountains here, the thing is pretty much void of any kind of insect life. So they do stock it lower down, but like, again, I've not really had a lot of luck. Yeah, you almost have to follow those stocking trucks probably, right? And try to get the fish before the mergansers do. I don't keep them, but that's the way it seems to work out. So we're going to head up towards the headwaters for the one of the headwaters for the East Pemigewasset River, and this is the Pemigewasset Wilderness that we're going to be heading into. So we're going to be taking the Black Pond Trail, which is 2.6 miles up the Lincoln Woods Trail here. Most of the people are going to be going up towards this Franconia Falls Trail that I referred to earlier. So we'll see a lot of people on the trail here, but once we cut off onto the Black Pond Trail, there's virtually no one on that trail. And that's another 0.8 to a mile up actually to Black Pond. So I wanted to give you an idea of what the trail looks like. It's really nice and gradual. It follows the river, so you always hear that nice little sound. And shoot, I didn't know you. Look at that. You can actually use bicycles on this trail. Now that's the great idea, huh? Now those people are all going up to that Franconia Falls, so you'll see them with their bathing suits and their towels. And I got to check it out. That sounds like a lot of fun. But it's a beautiful day, and this is a very easy gradual trail. In fact, I even saw a woman, a family coming down, and the older lady was in a wheelchair, so they were pushing a wheelchair, so it goes to show you, this is very accessible. And oh yeah, maybe I should show you right here. It's a, you do occasionally see these old railroad ties too, and this used to be an old railroad railroad bed, and you know, they did a lot of commercial logging. It wasn't until 1984 that this area got designated as a wilderness area and put under control by the U.S. National Forest. So none of the trees. I mean, you see a few big trees, but you know, a lot of this stuff, a lot of this area was harvested and logging business in the area years ago. But it's made a beautiful comeback, and it's a great, great area. Well, as you can see, it's really pretty. You can start to see some mountains up there. That's I'm going to guess that's the Bond mountain, and there's the Bond Cliff up there as well. From Black Pond, there's supposed to be some pretty scenic shots of it, but I'll have to check on a map later. But just wanted to give you this little scene here, because it's been pretty much like this the whole way up. And also I noticed that there's look at that, a railroad tie. And that's really kind of neat. Some of these things are pretty heavy, so, you know, no point in trying to carry them all out, but obviously quite a few of them were. So this is the trail to the Black Pond, and we'll start heading up this way, and within a mile we'll be doing some fishing. Well, probably halfway up towards Black Pond. It's supposedly this little bit of a swampy sort of area, but I also wanted to share with you that this is the trail, and compared to the trail to Franconia Falls, this makes me feel like that Robert Frost poem, you know, taking the path less traveled. Also looks like we're starting to get a little weather coming in here. It's supposed to be a nice sunny day, but those are a little bit of a storm cloud, so I'm hoping it doesn't rain. Well, welcome to Black Pond. Camping and fires are prohibited within 200 feet. So I haven't seen the pond yet, but it's probably just over this ridge right here, according to this little sign where it says, "You are here." So, well, we'll see it in a little bit. Well, we're coming up to the first view here. I'm going to guess that okay, so the pond is just the beginning of it. A little swampy exit. It looks like the pond's really over there. Wow, look at that. That view. That's a pretty mountain. Now, is that Bond? I think that is, because I think that's Bond Cliff, which you can see a little over to the right. So, well, let's go check it out. Also, I see something. I thought I saw something in the water. Taking a little nip at something here. That could just be bugs hatching, though. But that could also be a good sign, right? So this is really my first official view of Bond. Well, now of course I'll have to double check everything to try to tell you what mountain peaks these are, because the one I was looking at earlier I think was more over that way, which we really can't see right now from the trees. But boy, this sure is a pretty area, huh? So this is all part of this Franconia Ridge, you know, and trails and stuff that people take, you know, and climbing. You know, they climb right up there and then they walk along the ridge. And this is all in the Pemigewasset Wilderness area. And it looks like all those little bugs, whatever they call them, skimming bugs or something, you know, all running around the surface here. Boy, there's a ton of them. And I don't see anything fish activity, but it's still kind of early. And I think what I might want to do is I might want to walk around. And the trail goes around the pond. I may want to walk around, take a look, and check it out to see if there's some good spots to go fishing. You know, clearly I could get out there on the stones. I do have my waders, and it looks pretty stony even. So I could probably wade out here very easily if I wanted to. So, but I think right now I might want to head over that way and just check out this whole area. Grab something to eat. Beautiful day. And the other thing to point out is I'm the only one here. This pond is a lot more isolated than the other remote ponds that I've visited. Probably because everyone is pulled away by the Franconia Falls area. So A little bit of a surface ring right there. So there's got to be trout in here. Okay, so we're going to really have some fun today. I've got a very old Thomas special bamboo rod. And what makes it a little unique, it's probably the longest bamboo rod I've ever fished with. It's 9.5 feet, which back when this rod was made over 100 years ago, this is like, you know, circa before like 1898 to 1905 kind of thing. You'll notice that that's not it's a nice straight rod, but just the weight and the length of it makes it almost look like it has a little bit of a fishing set. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to wade out here. I don't really see any action, but you know, I'm going to throw a couple of nice, you know, like grasshopper type flies and see, and we'll just see if there's any action, right? So it does look like there's a little bit of a diving bird maybe way over there where I'm seeing, they usually know where the trout is. So I'm suspecting they're going to be, it seems like it's a little deeper here. So I'm thinking it's going to be out there. So I'm also going to try to set this up with a little tripod, and I'll put it on wide angle and do remote. So you can join me in my fishing. I am definitely not used to this long, very flexible, soft bamboo rod. I might have to switch over. But the fly lands nice. Wind is shifting all around. Okay, so for the next rod that I'm going to try here before I split, something a little more in my range, And this is a Goodwin Granger rod. It's referred to as a special. This it's not a Wright McGill. It is an actual Granger. So prior to World War II, and it is an 8040. So that means it's a 4 ounce. It's an 8 foot rod, and again, it's a little maybe a little bit of a fishing set in this one here. But this is a really nice little rod. I just acquired it just the other day at a Discovery auction, and I got it for very reasonable money. So no complaints there. So I'm going to tie on some flies, and then I'm going to put this. Well, we'll try our fishing again. Maybe I'll even try a little streamer or something like that. I think I can cast much further with this because it's a faster action rod than the old. Okay, so it's perched right over there in that little birch tree. I think it's making a little squeaking sound. I wanted to show you one of those bloodsuckers trying to come get me. By the time I got the camera turned on. Oh, there it is. Isn't that disgusting, huh? See the little orangish bottom? Those are big bloodsuckers, huh? Sneaky. I don't want to be pulling those things off, so I'm glad I got waders. Well, one last look at the bird. The big hawk with the white breast. The dark wings over there. I don't know how you can see it from here or not, but that was a pretty big bird. Still, there's really no action on the lake or pond, really. It's a 4-acre pond. So I've decided to pack things up and to head out. I probably need to check the time. It looks like it's probably going to be getting close to 5, so I probably want to get moving on out of here. And I got to bushwhack a little bit to get back to the trail from this nice little peninsula. Wind has completely died down. Feels a little more hot and muggy, so I'm gonna be drinking some water and heading back down and probably not doing a lot of filming. So this is your last look at a beautiful little black pond. It was pretty deep too. When I started to wade out the first time right out there, it immediately went up to my waist, and it was nice. Actually the cold water felt a little nice, you know, but I was surprised. It's a lot deeper than you might realize. And I did see some small fish as well, but I really couldn't make out what they were. They're kind of like all schooling around the rocks here, so they could just be dace or feed fish or things like that. So, but pretty pond, and obviously with the hawk, and I could have sworn I saw some kind of a diving bird over there earlier. There's definitely some decent sized fish in here. And once again, that's a pretty interesting looking bird. I wish it was flying again. I wish I had it on the wide angle sort of lens setting when it flew by. So I don't know if you probably had a chance to see it, but not as close as it was appearing to me. So that's another one of the reasons why I want to start moving on anyway, because it hasn't flown down and buzzed me yet. And I've had that happen before. So I think I kind of prefer not to have to experience that on my way out. So this is the little stream that feeds into the Pemigewasset, that where the Franconia Falls are further up there. I'm going to probably go up onto this bridge and I'll get a different view. Oh, that's a nice view. And we'll see if I can take a little look down there sunset wise. But real pretty. I was also able to check out my water and filtration system. So I actually made a thing of water and it works pretty good. I mean, at least it tastes really good. So that's awfully nice and refreshing, but this water certainly looked like it was a good candidate for filtration. So this is the river and the sun setting behind the mountains up there. That I'm not sure. Is that Lafayette maybe? Lincoln? But at any rate, this is the little stream that the Franconia Falls. I really wish I could have gone and checked it out. Looked like it was a great bathing suit place, and the water was really refreshing. And then down here is where I actually did the filtration stuff. But this is also this little river now. It will feed right into the Pemigewasset, which you can kind of see from the sun over there, sort of starting to come down. So all told, it's been a pretty nice day. Certainly. How can anyone complain about spending time in the White Mountains? It's really a lot of fun.